Nigeria to collaborate with other African countries for the successful implementation of the peace accord in South Sudan.
We're going to wait for the PIB law to do the issue of unbundling of NMPs in sense of difference.
Unbundling or restructuring, Minister of State Petroleum Resources provides clarification at the National Assembly. And strategy to enhance security of lives and property, Nigeria Police gets a dog training center. Good evening and thanks for joining us on the NTA Network News at 9. I am Fumi Wakama. President Muhammadu Buhari has promised to collaborate with other African leaders towards ensuring that the peace agreement signed by the various political factions in South Sudan is implemented successfully for unity, stability and development. The president made the promise in an audience with the Vice President of South Sudan, Rick Michel, in Abuja. State House correspondent Adamu Sambo has the report.
Dr. Rick Tenidogo is in Nigeria to brief President Muhammadu Buhari on the current state of affairs in South Sudan. President Buhari told the Vice President, as signatory to the peace pact, that he and other African leaders are concerned that compliance with the ceasefire agreement in his country has not been effective. The situation, he insists, must not deteriorate. The president therefore promised to do his utmost best under the platform of the African Union High-Level Consultative Committee on South Sudan towards achieving the desired stability. He said other stakeholders are also to be involved in the peace initiative in order to overcome problems hindering the implementation of the seven-month-old agreement. President Buhari, however, advised the visiting Vice President of South Sudan to do his best with other leaders to prevent ethnicity and corruption from gaining a foothold in the new country. He said unless this is done, instability will continue in South Sudan. In a related development, President Buhari also received a special envoy of the African Union Chairman, President Idris Deby of Chad. The envoy, Abubakar Saleh Chahimi, delivered a message to the Nigerian leader on the work of the African Union Consultative Committee on South Sudan, as well as the desire of Chad to strengthen relations with Nigeria. From the State House, Adamu Sambo, NTA News.
At the National Assembly, the Senate has resolved to investigate the non-completion of two Escravos gas projects, now 8 years behind schedule. National Assembly correspondent Muhammad Ali reports that the Senate has also resolved to review laws establishing the Federal Road Safety Commission, the Federal Road Maintenance Agency, and the Vehicle Inspection Office, VIO, with a view to bringing sanity on Nigerian roads.
The Escravos Gas Project and Escravos Gas to Liquid Project commenced in 2003 with a completion period of 60 months. 8 years after, the project is still ongoing. That informed the decision of Senator Hope Uzodinma from Imo State to move this motion.
The project has suffered more hiccups and price variations than others in its class, in absolute conflict with the interests of the government and the people of Nigeria.
The issue generated a lot of interest. Senators took turn to make contributions.
The joint venture partners are requiring the federal government to bring further money to be able to complete it. Meanwhile, at the beginning, they were given the required money 100%.
The motive to make profit by these JV partners is what is driving them not to complete this project.
Let us know what is happening, honestly.
Senator Ali Wakili from Bauchi State moved a motion on what he describes as the pandemic rise of road traffic accidents in Nigeria.
Urge all relevant agencies of government, especially the FIRS and the police, to be alive to their responsibilities in checking the state of vehicles, drivers, loading, and related approved motor parks logistics.
How sure are we that SEMA is receiving this money from PPRE?
Let's amend the bill that was established, the act that was established in 2002.
If the relevant laws are amended, then I think that we'll go further than that.
Two bills on Nigerian Peace Corps, Youth Orientation and Development, National Ethics, discipline and productivity by Senate leader Muhammad Ali Ndume and Senator Bintamasi Garba from Adamawa State were consolidated and referred to the Senate Committee on Interior for further action. The legislators also considered and adopted reports from four committees, including the Joint Committee on Health and Agriculture, which made recommendations on the ban on Nigeria agricultural products by the European Union. Six new bills were read for the first time.
The Senate do adjourn to Tuesday, the 15th day of March 2016, at 10 a.m. prompt.
From the National Assembly, Mohammed Ali, NTA News.
And still staying with the National Assembly, the recent move to unbundle the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, NNPC, as widely reported, has generated a lot of controversy in the country. And with the dwindling fortune in the oil sector and its impact on the economy, the Minister of State Petroleum Resources, Dr. Ibeka Chukwu, has fielded questions from the Joint Senate Committees on Petroleum, Upstream and Gas on the matter. National Assembly correspondent Dennis Adegunloye has that report.
And also, to know why the Senate was not consulted at all before this type of thing happened.
If you can't tell everybody, at least the chairman of our committees ought to know, so that we can even be your defenders when this comes in the public domain.
Public perception, they say, is everything, and those were some senators voicing the agitation felt over the issue of the reported unbundling of the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, NNPC. They further raised concerns on what extent the reform of the NNPC will be accommodated by the Petroleum Industry Bill when passed. The Minister of State Petroleum Resources, Ibeka Chukwu, who is also the Group Managing Director of the NNPC, however, made these clarifications.
We're going to wait for the PIB law to do the issue of unbundling of NNPC in sense of different arms, or whether it's NOC, asset management company, or the rest. And I've worked very collaboratively with the Senate leadership on that aspect.
The National Assembly, while appreciating the submissions of the Minister of State, urged more transparency. An executive session followed after the open interactions. From the National Assembly, Dennis Adigunloye, NTA News.
The House of Representatives has reiterated its position on the planned unbundling of NNPC by the Minister of State for Petroleum Resources and Group Managing Director, NNPC, Dr. Ibeka Chukwu. The Chairman, House Committee on Media and Public Affairs, Representative Abdulrazak Namdas, while briefing National Assembly correspondents, said the House is resolute in carrying out the investigation.
The Speaker of the House of Representatives has put calls to the President on three occasions, asking Mr. President to at least send an executive bill for the petroleum industry bill or petroleum reform, as it may suit them. You are already aware that we don't have a bill before us in the 8th House of Representatives. What happened was in the 7th. We don't have that in the 8th House of Representatives. So because part of the legislative agenda is for the quick passage of also this petroleum bill, but we have asked Mr. President to bring that to us so that we can also be on the same page and pass it on time.
Still staying with the petroleum resources sector, Pengasin and Nupeng have called off their day-old strike which shut NNPC operations. The strike started yesterday following restructuring of the NNPC, as announced by the Minister of State for Petroleum Resources and Group Managing Director of the NNPC, Dr. Ibeka Chukwu. Makut Simon Macham has an update.
This is the entrance to the NNPC towers. Yesterday, there was a blockade by the unions here at the NNPC towers. We are not allowed to film here because of the tension here yesterday. But today, there is free access. As you can see, vehicles are going in and there is no restraint. This is because the unions have met with the minister, we understand, and other officials to discuss the restructuring of the NNPC. But what has this caused? If you look to my right, you will see then that it has created the hiccup within just a day. For those of you who are familiar with the fuel stations opposite the NNPC mega station, if I may describe a bit, before you get fuel now at either Corn Oil or Total, you have to queue up from this part of the road, and then you go round and round and round. So the queue is unusually long, and this is because of the hiccup yesterday.
I'm here since 4 a.m. Okay. In the morning, and I've never got fuel. This is to 10. We don't know whether they are even selling there now, sir.
Since yesterday, around 10 o'clock, we have been queuing here, and the line is not even moving. I'm not even sure if we can get the fuel.
Governments will find a solution for it, because it's all of us in Nigeria that we suffer all these things.
We'll continue to look at the situation, and as it evolves, we'll be feeding you. But for now, the queues are still long, and the motorists are hoping that this will change in the coming days. Now, back to you in the studio.
Thank you, Makut. We expect the federal capital to be wet in a couple of hours. The House of Representatives has moved against incidents of unsolicited telephone calls and text messages by mobile telephone service providers. The bill to that effect has passed second reading. National Assembly correspondent Ignatius Nkor reports that a group of lawmakers from the Ekiti State House of Assembly have commended the House of Representatives for what it described as appropriate legislative action towards resolving the ongoing crisis in Ekiti.
One of the complaints Nigerians have against the various mobile telecommunication service providers is unsolicited phone calls and text messages. Members of the House of Representatives unanimously condemned this act through a bill sponsored by Representative Aliyu Madaki from Kano State.
We should do everything possible to strengthen the NCC, to align itself with what is obtainable everywhere in the world. Our telephones are meant for communication, not for harassment.
Is to send this bill to the committee, let them call for the public hearing on it, and let the experts discuss this and advise us.
Another bill that passed second reading was that for an act to amend the Companies and Allied Matters Act, seeking to empower the Commission to make its rules and regulations, sponsored by Representative Ibrahim Sadiq from Adamawa State.
Companies and Allied Matters Act, which unfortunately, Mr. Speaker, has not given the Corporate Affairs Commission the power to make regulations for the governing of registration of companies in Nigeria. And this to me, Mr. Speaker, is a serious lacuna.
The House also adopted a motion on the need for the federal government to intensify efforts to check illegal possession of firearms across the country, moved by Representative Olusegun Odubemi from Oyo State.
A situation that substantially contributes to the high rates of insecurity and crime in the country.
United Nations, ECOWAS, everybody came up and said that every country had to set up a commission against the proliferation of small arms and light weapons.
The legislators received the reproduced copies of the House Code of Conduct as presented by the Chairman House Committee on Ethics and Privileges, Representative Nicholas Osai. The House is working towards enacting law that will establish the Federal Capital Territory Civil Service Commission. This was contained in the Speaker's message delivered at the opening of a two-day public hearing on Bill for an Act to Establish a Public Service Commission for the FCT.
I therefore wish to solicit your indulgence to kindly make meaningful and lawless contributions towards achieving the goals for the establishment of the FCT Public Service Commission.
A group of legislators from the Ekiti State House of Assembly, led by its chairman, House Committee on Information, Boyega Aribishogun, visited the National Assembly, where they commended the House for their intervention in the crisis in the Ekiti State House of Assembly. From the National Assembly, Ignatius Nkwo, NTA News.
Meanwhile, the Senate has commenced investigation into why and how the MTN, a mobile service provider, made part payment of 50 billion naira out of 780 billion naira fine imposed on it for contravening the directive on deactivation of about 5 million unregistered subscribers. An issue raised was payment into the recovery account of the CBN instead of the coffers of the Nigerian Communications Commission. National Assembly correspondent Grace Oyenubi has details.
It becomes imperative for the committee to wade into the matter with special attention to the controversy surrounding the payment of 50 billion naira by MTN.
I, as an individual, never played a role in regard to how much sanctions will be paid, in regard to whether there be a review or not. We tried to find out where this payment was made, and we did not get any answer. It was not paid into the NCC account domicile in the Central Bank of Nigeria.
So it was an instruction from the Attorney General's office to make this payment.
I'm aware that there was a request to open recovery account, which came from the Ministry of Justice.
They are from South Africa. Can Nigerian company go and decide to negotiate with other agencies without, maybe in South Africa, without if the Ministry of Communication there?
They've given you the terms of what they are paying in the total amount of financial settlement, 300 billion.
The document is a proposal. Is there anything wrong with that? The proposal said, I am offering this. Have we agreed? No, the case is still in court because we are going back on the 18th.
NCC has been fining telecoms operators for years. And the fines go into a particular account. And the NCC renders account to the federal government. Yes. How did it change? Why did it change? Because you see, when you have an independent institution, you must allow it remain so, without interference.
The Senate Committee Chairman on Communication, Senator Naji, then appealed to the Attorney General's office to always involve the Ministry of Communications and the Nigerian Communications Commission in further negotiations as it relates to the fine imposed on MTN. The hearing continues in 2 weeks. From the National Assembly, Grace Oyenubi, NTA News. Implementation of the Sustainable Development Goals in Nigeria will soon begin. Senior Special Assistant to the President on SDGs, Adejoke Adefoluri, said this at a conference of African parliamentarians holding in Abuja on SDGs. Claire Abderabu Abdurazak has the report.
Development experts say the role of parliamentarians is critical to achieving the SDGs and ensuring that no one is left behind. At the first All-African Parliamentarians Conference in Abuja, Chairman House Committee on the SDGs, Tijani Abdulkadri Jobe, said unlike the MDGs, parliamentarians played a very active role in the formulation of the SDGs.
Parliamentarians can do so by drafting laws and overseeing the government execution of these laws, national policies and strategic plans.
Chairman African Network of Parliamentarians on SDGs, Alhassan Adodogua, said Nigeria can also leverage on the MDGs' strategies.
I want to believe that what Nigeria did under the MDGs was a perfect job. We had a perfect job because we stood as the only country that had succeeded in securing the MDGs not only at the federal level. We also had the MDGs at the local government level.
New Senior Special Assistant to the President on SDGs, Princess Adejoke Adefoluri, said activities to kickstart implementation of the SDGs in Nigeria will soon commence.
This includes high-level sensitization, advocacy and mobilization of stakeholders, development of communication strategy for the SDG, strengthening arrangement of the public launch of SDG in our country, Nigeria.
She expressed optimism that the SDGs will be met. In Abuja, Claire Adelabu Abdurazak, NTA News.
The Ministry of Defense has refuted media reports which say Nigeria has requested South Africa to send special forces to help Nigeria in the fight against Boko Haram. A statement from the Ministry of Defense says there was never a time that the Minister of Defense made such a statement or alluded to it. The statement further adds that though the Minister of Defense, Mansour Muhammad Dan Ali, recently hosted his South African counterpart where they discussed bilateral issues bordering on transfer on skills, technology, research and development. Ahead on the news tonight, Nigeria joins the rest of the world to celebrate Kidney Day. Details when we come back.
If you hear a bomb explosion or gunshots of an active shooter, that might be a terror attack. At such times, always remember three action words. Run, hide, report. Don't try to run towards the terror scene to save the situation, because there might be a second bomb blast or another attack. Run far away and take cover. Make sure you are safe first. Yes, it is in our nature to sympathize over the hurt, But remember, only trained personnel can help in such situations. When in a secured environment, promptly call relevant authorities and help will come. For anonymous reporting, call 09630-3250 to 5 or 0813-2222-106. If you see something, say something. Nigeria, unite against terrorism. This message is brought to you by the Federal Ministry of Information and Culture. Join the Airtel family today and get 5 times the value of every recharge. Recharge with *555 star pin hash on the Airtel network and feel at home. Airtel, the smartphone network.
Our founding fathers worked to establish certain standards of governance. Some of their successors behaved like spoiled children, breaking everything and bringing disorder to the house.
The leaders at that time, as well as those of us that followed them, were patriotic. They went into politics to serve, but not to be served.
It is people doing things wrong and not being sanctioned that led to this escalation.
What is going on now? We are beginning to lift up the quality of leadership.
We must not succumb to hopelessness and defeatism. We can fix our problems.
What are these vaccinators still looking for? I thought Nigeria has been delisted from polio-endemic countries. Please don't allow them to drop anything in your child's mouth. We don't need the vaccine again.
That's not exactly true. Delisting Nigeria from polio endemic countries does not mean a stop to immunizing our children against polio.
So what does it mean?
You see, one cannot be sure that a poisonous snake is dead until the head is cut off. We have to sustain the momentum through scheduled polio vaccinations to guarantee a polio-free Nigeria from 2017.
I see a sense in that.
Even our president, Muhammadu Buhari, showed us an example by vaccinating his granddaughter against polio.
That means governors, council chairmen, traditional rulers, religious leaders, development partners, and everybody must follow the example of the president.
Ensure that all children under 5 are vaccinated against polio and other childhood killer diseases. Let's make Nigeria polio-free from 2017. This message is from National Primary Healthcare Development Agency.
Fairy is now in Nigeria, and Fairy is so powerful, even one drop is effective on 100% oily grease. Because Fairy is the best, it removes oily grease easily. Wow, it's squeaky clean. Fairy is the best at removing oily grease.
There is a reason Africa is called the new frontier. What was once potential is now an opportunity ready to be seized. Once revered for our resources, today's wealth lies in our people. People who build the cities that shape the future. People who know an idea in one place means business in another. A generation for whom technology means there are no borders, no boundaries. We are the new lions in a brave new world, kings of the urban jungle. And there's a bank that puts the world in our pocket and the future in our hands. UBA, Africa's global bank.
You get 3 kinds of moms. The paranoid mom. The cautious mom. And the Dettol mom. She only trusts Dettol antiseptic liquid to protect her family from up to 100 illness-causing germs, and it's recommended for cuts and scrapes. Which is why you can worry less and love more. Don't just be any mom, be a Dettol mom.
Join infrastructure investors and PPP advisors at the Nigeria Public-Private Partnership Conference 2016, Nigeria's first infrastructure investment promotion conference and exhibition. This conference is a must-attend event for industry players and governments interested in participating in Nigeria's PPP market. Venue, Transcorp Hilton Hotel, Abuja. Date 15 to 16th of March 2016, Nigerian Public-Private Partnership Conference 2016, accelerating investment in Nigeria's infrastructure.
If you're just joining us, this is the NTA Network News, and we begin this segment at the courts. The Federal High Court sitting in Abuja has granted bail to former Chief of Defence Staff, Air Chief Marshal Alex Buddy, who is currently being held at the Kuje Medium Security Prisons in Abuja. Isaac Nkuma has the report.
Ruling on the bail application, Justice Okon Abang said the court has balanced the competing arguments of rights and issues of fear of bail jump as tendered by both parties. He granted bail to the defendant, Alex Bade, in the sum of 2 billion naira with two sureties in the sum of 1 billion naira each, and they must reside and have landed property in the FCT and with 3 years' tax clearance. They are also to submit 2 passport photographs and swear an affidavit of means, as well as deposit the original title deeds of the property with the court's chief registrar. The court registrar is directed to verify the genuineness of the certificate of occupancy of the landed property and also its market value, while the EFCC will also independently carry out investigations on the documents tendered by the sureties.
Seems like it's too stringent.
They are not. It's okay. Yes, the conditions are okay. No. We shall meet the conditions by the grace of God.
How soon?
Within the next 48 hours.
We felt that this case should not be released on bail because of his antecedent and what he's capable of doing. So we felt that he's not entitled to bail.
Alex Bade is facing a 10-count charge of money laundering and misappropriation of Nigerian Air Force funds to the tune of 3 billion naira. He is to deposit his international passport with the chief registrar of the court. Trial on the matter will resume on Monday, March 14th. In Abuja, Isaac Nkuma, NTA News.
And to security matters, in its commitment to reduce insurgency and other social vices to the barest minimum, the police has constructed a dog breeding center, the first in sub-Saharan Africa, to groom formidable force animals that will complement the technical and human assets of the force. Bonaventure Mwodo has that report.
The Minister of Interior, Abdulrahman Dambazau, who commissioned the center, said breeding specialized dogs and other animals would enhance national security and create job opportunities.
My relationship with the Nigerian police and what I have seen the Inspector General of Police has done and executed, I believe strongly that we are on the right path.
The Inspector General of Police, Solomon Arasa, said the center has the capacity to breed and supply police dogs to entire West African sub-region and place Nigeria among nations with professional canine ability.
Huge funds were being expended on importation of dogs from foreign countries. Yet, some of these dogs rarely adapt to our policing climes. This is certainly not sustainable, especially in the face of the current dwindling resources.
The center is expected to produce 200 dogs per year and is supported by Canadian government to help police develop capacity and maintain sustenance. In Abuja, Bonaventure Wood, NTA News.
And to health matters, the 58th National Council on Health has opened in Sokoto with focus on universal health coverage as agenda for change. This is in view of President Muhammadu Buhari's promise to support the universal health coverage agenda. Health correspondent Rabi Abdallah reports that the meeting was declared open by Sokoto State Governor Aminu Waziri Tambuwal.
The National Council on Health, which is held annually, is the highest policy-making body in the Nigerian health sector. It is convened to enable key players in the sector to deliberate on issues of national importance to health. The renewed impetus on universal health coverage at the 58th regular session of the meeting also arises from the fact that almost 11 years after the launch of the National Health Insurance Scheme, out-of-pocket spending on health in Nigeria remains a huge challenge.
All participants must therefore embrace the golden opportunity provided by this platform to ensure that issues are thoroughly and objectively appraised, to establish opportunities for innovative financing and domestic resource mobilization.
We have already passed a bill, and it has had the first reading of the National Health Insurance, in what we call it the Mandatory Health Contributory Management Agency in our state.
So one of the things in NHIS that we are bringing on as innovation is what we call the State Social Health Insurance Program, whereby we are actually collaborating with states to set up a state contributory health scheme that can actually be a pool of funds that will take care of the health needs of the citizens and residents in those states.
The slow progress or non-implementation of resolutions from previous National Council on Health meeting was one the minister said is unacceptable. He therefore urged key players at this meeting to brainstorm on how to tackle the bottlenecks that hinder the implementation of resolutions from council meetings. From Sokoto, this is Rabi Abdallah, NTA News.
Thank you, Rabi. As Nigeria joins the rest of the world to mark World Kidney Day, various groups have called for legislation that will address the plight of kidney patients in Nigeria. Salihu Abdullahi has that report.
Kidney Day is to raise awareness of the importance of kidneys to human life. It is a day that experts and health practitioners use to educate people on how to reduce the frequency and impact of kidney disease and its associated health problems. This group in Abuja have decided to key into the theme for this year's celebration, which is Kidney Disease and Children, Act Early to Prevent It. This they did with a rally to the National Assembly, where they presented a letter to the leadership of the two chambers.
The kidney, because of the special position in the body, even in this year's budget, we have some attention on having dialysis centers in some areas in the country so that every ward in Nigeria will have a primary health care center.
The major thing I want them to do for us, recognize the kidney foundations that are working. They fund the hospitals very well. The government hospitals are well funded with enough infrastructure to encourage patients to have their dialysis in Nigeria, because there's a lot of capital flights going on.
World Kidney Day is celebrated on the second Thursday of March each year. This year's celebration features 600 events across 90 countries worldwide. Salihu Abdullahi, NTN.
And to politics, the national chairman of the Social Democratic Party, Olufalai, has said that the party will boycott local government elections in Ondo State scheduled for next month. He stated these after the national convention of the party held in Abuja. Abdullahi Suleiman Yaji reports.
That the existing National Executive Committee of SDP Nigeria be dissolved.
That signaled the commencement of the convention to elect national executive officers of the Social Democratic Party for the 45 vacant seats in contention. Chairman of the party, Chief Olufalai, was returned unopposed while voting held for the positions of the Deputy National Chairman, which went to Abdul Ahmed, National Secretary, won by Saleh Das, and Alfa Mohammed emerged as the National Publicity Secretary.
Local government elections are coming up in Ondo State in April. The SDP will not participate in those elections.
Both the winners and the losers, the way they have behaved to the expectation of our party members.
Earlier, some delegates protested the accreditation process. However, the situation was brought under control. In Abuja, Abdullahi Suleiman Iyaji, NTA News.
The federal government has appointed Dr. Dakoko Peterside as the Director General of the Nigerian Maritime Administration and Safety Agency, NIMASA. A statement from the Director of Press and Public Relations, Ministry of Transportation, Yetunde Shonaike, says the appointment is with immediate effect. Dr. Peter Said, who holds a doctorate degree in management science, was the governorship candidate of the All Progressives Congress APC in the 2015 governorship election in Rivers State. Head of Service on Developing the Public Sector, Ademola brings us details from our Lagos Network Center. A very good evening to you, Ademola.
Good evening to you, Fumi, and welcome to Lagos. Human capacity development, entrepreneurial reorientation of the workforce, and effective digitization operations have been identified as key elements towards evolving a viral civil service. Head of the Civil Service of the Federation, Winifred Oyoita, said this at a business forum in Lagos. Jane Ojukwu has the report.
Mrs. Oyoita cited lack of attention to the civil service and inadequate training of its workforce as some of the major setbacks against its optimum productivity. She unveiled her reform program designed to ensure increased productivity and a vibrant civil service.
It is very important that we improve our training and the capacity building of our civil servants, because if we need them to run with the vision of government, the policy thrust of this administration, they have to be very well trained.
Mrs. Oyoita said the service will not tolerate any unwholesome practice in line with the administration's stance on corruption. She, however, made some promises on the civil servants' welfare.
We have developed the Federal Integrated Staff Housing Program, which is an inter-ministerial program.
Some participants react.
The head of the civil service was able to, show us the plans that she has, which she intends to transform the civil service to make them more productive and to make them more relevant in today's economy.
We are so happy with the level of commitment and passion she has demonstrated. It clearly shows that she understands the requirements of actually leading this country out of our current economic challenges.
Head of Civil Service of the Federation is looking forward to a world-class civil service for the country. In Lagos, Jane Ojukwu, NTN News.
Well, that's our package from Lagos. We now take a break for some messages, after which the news continues from Abuja. Stay with us.
Nigerians. Suicide bombers are not spirits. They are not ghosts. They are human beings like you and me. They live amongst us. They are your neighbors. They are your friends today, but terrorists tomorrow. So you must know your neighbor now. Security begins with you and me. Know your neighbor. Be vigilant. Be security conscious. Report suspicious persons, objects, and movements to the police and other security agencies. The security of our nation is a duty for you and me.
If you see something, say something. Nigeria, unite against terrorism.
This message is brought to you by the Federal Ministry of Information and Culture.
Join the Airtel family today and then get 5 times the value of every recharge. Recharge with *555 star pin hash on the Airtel network and feel at home. Airtel, the smartphone network.
She gave me a very motherly slap.
Pays my school fees and allowed me to have the opportunity to go to school.
Beat me for what I used to do wrong, but she's still my best mom.
She
She likes wearing red-made clothes.
My mom is the one that makes me to survive because of she's the one that gives me food every day.
It's hard. I always pay my school fees every day.
Finally, our first gig. The whole school is here. And that's when I spot her, my secret muse. Ah, that was awful. I froze. I couldn't move. Pretty Fanta.
Fanta!
Great flavor. Play it better with Fanta.
Good moms know how to prepare their kids for greatness by giving them Milo with breakfast every morning. And now, Milo has Active Gold, a special blend of protobalt, vitamins, and minerals uniquely mixed with milk and cocoa to bring you the winning energy of Milo. Milo, the energy food drink of future champions.
Nestle, good food, good life.
You're still watching the NTA Network News. President Muhammadu Buhari receives commendation for ongoing reforms in mining, oil and gas sectors. Details with Vivian Idipefo on Business News.
Thank you for joining us on the Business News segment. The Extractive Industries Transparency Initiative has commended President Muhammadu Buhari for adopting recommendations of its Nigerian office in implementing reforms in the mining, oil and gas sectors. The commendation was at the 7th Global Conference of the EITI in Lima, Peru, where Nigeria's Minister of State for Budget and National Planning, Zainab Ahmed, was among those inaugurated as members of the EITI Global Board.
The work that NIT does is a very, very important work, and I'm glad that the current administration of President Muhammadu Buhari is actually using the NIT audit reports to make much-needed improvements in both the oil and gas and the mining sector.
But now, to the great credit your country has elected this reforming government, they're picking up the EITI report recommendations and they're driving them into real reform in the sector.
The reconstitution of the new multi-stakeholders working group for NATI was also commended as timely as it averted Nigeria's suspension from the global body. Stockbrokers of the Nigerian Stock Exchange who engage in unauthorized sale of clients' shares risk a fine of 5 million naira in addition to other penalties. This is contained in the amended rules of the NSE as approved by the Securities and Exchange Commission in December 2015. A statement from the Nigerian Stock Exchange explains that the amendment became necessary to protect investors and instill more discipline in the market. That concludes Business News. Thanks for being there. Good evening.
Thank you, Vivian. And Sokoto Network Center is where we go next to join Zainab for happenings in the seat of the Caliphate. Good evening, Zainab.
Fumi and welcome. Poor funding, relegating education sector to the background and inability to convert ideas into products have been identified as major challenges militating against the advancement of Nigeria's education sector. These were the views of intellectuals at the first international conference on education organized by the Sokoto State University, and Shehu Muhammad Dutti was there for NTA News.
The theme of the first international conference is human security and challenges of innovative education. Declaring the conference open, Sokoto State Governor Aminu Oziri Tambal, represented by Secretary to the State Government, Professor Bashir Garba, said the choice of the topic is timely, considering the contemporary challenges of security in Nigeria, especially in the Northeast. Convener of the conference and Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Nuhu Yakub, said security challenge is a global phenomenon, hence the need to educate people on its adverse effect. He identified terrorism, poverty, ignorance and diseases as negative effects that have affected not only Nigeria, but other countries of the world.
We expect that this conference will come up with new approaches, dynamics in education sector. There are probably new theories that we're not aware of.
Professor Peter Okebukola described human security as a means of being free of threats, hunger, and being empowered, among others. Goodwill messages were delivered by representatives of universities, chairman, governing board, and scholars of great refuge from various institutions. In Sokoto, Show Muhammad Detti, NTA News.
And that's it from here. It's back to you, Fumi. Good evening.
Thank you, Zainab. Minister of State for Education, Professor Anthony Anwuka, has called on parents, teachers, and other key players to sensitize students on new career prospects in the field of light. Minister stated this at the UNESCO's International Year of High and Light-Based Technology celebration. Abdullahi Musa Suleja has details.
Experts believe that science and technology of light and numerous applications of light-based technologies have revolutionized the society in various fields, such as medicine, entertainment, information, and communications. The Minister of State, Professor Anthony Anwuka, said light-based science students have the capacity to move the country to greater height in various fields of human endeavor.
Light is life. Light is knowledge. Light is empowerment, and above all, light is basic human existence.
Permanent Secretary, Minister of Education, Fola Shadeyemi, also said the occasion is a unique opportunity to educate and promote career and inspire a new generation to study science through light.
It is hopeful that the insights that we will share today will spur all stakeholders to come out with new ideas and inventions in the application of light-based technologies for the benefit of mankind.
The event featured exhibition of light-based innovations by some secondary school students. The theme of the year's celebration is harnessing light and light-based technologies for sustainable development. In Abuja, Abdullahi Musa Suleja, NTA News.
Time now to join Agatha in Benin for details of Governor Oshiomhole's inspection of projects in Edo State. Good evening, Agatha.
Good evening, Fumi. Thanks for joining us in Benin. Edo State Governor Adams Oshiomhole has positioned himself to finish strong. He has therefore redoubled the inspection of projects to ensure that they are delivered on schedule, including the New Era College in Benin. The report.
When completed, the New Era College will have a library, fine and applied arts, chemistry, physics, and biology laboratories. Governor Oshiomhole expressed satisfaction with what is on ground. He urged the workers to speed up work and maintain quality.
The whole idea is to return New Era to what it should be, to make it one of the modern schools, returning to body system and ensuring that the pupils have a secondary school that compares to none other anywhere in the country.
The reconstruction of the school is in fulfillment of the governor's promise to commence another round of school's rehabilitation with 3 billion naira already set aside for the purpose. It is in line with his agenda to finish well and strong.
And that's our package. Fumi, it's back to you for the rest of the network news. Good evening.
Thank you, Agatha. Global tidbits and sports are next on our lineup.
Healthy. I take time to make everything look clean.
Yes, but is it really clean? Let me show you. This is why 80% of hygiene-related illnesses are acquired at home. Some cleaners don't kill germs, others kill germs, but don't clean properly. The new Dettol Multi-Surface Cleaner. 10 times better germ kill. 10 times better cleaning and all-day freshness. 10 times better cleaning and germ kill for a healthy home.
Dettol, endorsed by the Nigerian Medical Association.
Buy the new Dettol 55-gram soap for 80 naira only. Keep your family protected from germs.
So, how far now? Don't do so. My promo. Use the phone become millionaire.
You never hear? Say, NAFTA don't bring within the call mobile authentication service. We could help us know whether medicine na fake or not before we pay. Now, consider. As I scratch this thing, we be like recharge card. So, call send the PIN to 38353, free of charge. I will call receive text message to confirm. Okay, original.
Choy, just like that, we confirm whether medicine now fake or not instantly.
That way, you self don't wise up. Make you help not that spread the story not the way that. Madam, come and take your money.
Now, National Agency for Food and Drug Administration and Control, NAFDAC, they bring on this message.
Turning to the foreign scene now, Myanmar's National League for Democracy names presidential candidates as it rolls out leader Aung San Suu Kyi as contender. Details with Talatu Ezurike.
In Niger, as the citizens await the presidential runoff slated for 28 March, that might likely grant the sitting president, Mahamudu Yusufu, a second term. However, the opposition coalition stands its ground that jailed candidate Hama Amadou, the strongest contender, will boycott the race. Still in Africa, confusion Sierra Leone over the arrest of a former leader of a pro-government militia that operated during the country's civil war. According to the police, they have not received direct orders from the UN-backed War Crimes Court for the arrest. Also, the convicted killer of anti-apartheid struggle hero Chris Hani in 1993 has won an appeal to be released on parole. Similarly, an ambush on a military convoy escorting food aid trucks in Darfur, Sudan, has claimed the life of a South African peacekeeper while another was injured. And German police are investigating documents said to reveal the identities of a large number of Islamic State fighters and their supporters from 50 countries. That is all on Global Tidbits. Talati Ezurike, NTA News.
And here is Kene Emawudike with our sports update.
Home-based Super Eagles continue their training at the main bowl of the Abuja National Stadium as they prepare for the crucial 2017 Africa Cup of Nations qualifiers against Egyptian Pharaohs on March 25 in Kaduna. The invited foreign-based players are still being expected ahead of the team's departure to Kaduna on March 21. Coach Samson Siasia has equally given March 21 as the deadline for the arrival of the foreign-based players. Flamingos of Nigeria have asked fans to come cheer them to victory against South Africa in the first leg final round 2016 World Cup qualifier billed for Saturday at the Abuja National Stadium.
They don't look like a team that can disappoint anybody. So I pray that Nigerians will always give us the support.
Nasarawa United of Lafia are preparing to welcome Constantine of Algeria in the first leg second round CAF Confederation Cup tie on Sunday at the Abuja National Stadium.
We have worked on their mistakes and their lapses that we know they have, and they have responded very well.
Meanwhile, Nigeria's oldest boxer, Bash Ali, who hosted a press conference in Abuja in the week, insists that Nigeria stands to gain a lot from his proposed Guinness World Record fight.
This fight will cost about $48 million and will bring nothing less than $750 million to the country from pay-per-view television.
However, Director of Grassroots Sports Development in the National Sports Commission, Ademola Are, says the proposed bout may not happen as long as due processes are not followed.
The NBBFC, the only body that is in charge of professional boxing, is not involved in what it's doing.
Bash Ali, who turns 60 on Saturday, has been working on the proposed Guinness World Record fight for about a decade now. With Sports Update, Kene Ima Abudike, NTA News.
And sympathizers have continued to visit the family of the late Minister of State, Labour and Employment, James Ocholi. Salihu Abdullahi has a roll call of visitors to the Kado residence of the deceased.
Of the sympathizers who spoke with NTA shortly after their visit to the family expressed shock that James Ocholi died as a result of avoidable circumstances. They added that his positive contributions to the development of his state of origin, Kogi, and to the country in general will forever be remembered.
We are pre-seeking the face of course, the intervention of God to intervene in our state to bring this sudden death to an end.
About a month ago, I was with him in his office, and
we paid the courtesy visit where he expressed his interest to even go into the matter that has been lingering within the ministry that is ready to resolve for the organization.
They expressed the hope that the dreams of James Ocholi in building a united Nigeria through the change agenda he keyed into will come to reality. They commended the federal government's show of love and support and promised to consolidate on every effort to ensure the well-being of the family Ocholi left behind.
And therefore, as is normal in our community, his family is our responsibility. We continue to interact with them, advise them.
I believe that God is the only one that will help us to be able to cope with this.
In Abuja, Salihu Abdullahi, NTA News.
The remains of Chief of Training and Operations at the Nigerian Army Headquarters, Major General Yushau Abubakar, has been laid to rest at Gundi Akwati Village in Barkinladi local government area of Plateau State. Yusuf Umar reports that top hierarchy of the Nigerian Army was present at the burial.
Remains of the deceased arrived at the village at exactly 4:45 in the evening, where the immediate family were allowed to pay their last respect, after which the funeral prayers commenced.
Spearheading the beginning of the defeat of the Boko Haram terrorists. Present successes will greatly attribute it to him.
This is a big loss, not to the family, not to Plateau State, but to Nigeria.
His elder brother, Alhaji Shehu Abubakar, he described the late general as a humane but courageous man.
It was outstanding because he turned the tides at Lafia Dole.
Born 24th December 1960, the late general joined the Nigerian Army in 1984 and served at different formations and commands at different levels, both within and outside the country. The late general was the first commandant, Theater Command Operation in Maiduguri, tagged Operation Zamolafia Dole, and was later transferred to the Army headquarters as Chief of Training and Operation Army, a position he held until this sad event. He is married to two wives, seven children, and many relations. From Gindina Kwati village in Barik Ladi local government area of Plateau State, Yusuf Umar, NTA News.
And here's the latest on our weather forecast.
And welcome to weather forecast for Friday. We expect stable conditions on Friday morning with cloudy conditions over the southern half of the country, while the northern fringes will be under sunny conditions. However, it's possible that the high grounds of Abuja could experience some isolated rainfall in the morning as a result of spillover of activities of yesterday. And for the afternoon forecast, isolated thunder with rain are expected over the high grounds of the central states, areas around the Mambila, the southeast coast, and some parts of the high grounds of the southwest. And for the maximum temperature and minimum temperature, let's take a look. And that will be all from the Nigerian Meteorological Agency. Join us again.
And that brings us to the end of NETOSK News for tonight. We thank you for being a part of it. I am Fumi Wakama. Good night.